Hello, my name is Donaldo, and for part 2 of our GaN Power Switch Fundamental Series, we will be going over some of the Enhancement Mode GaN FET driving requirements. We will be going over some of the GaN FET's advantages, its structure benefits, and finish with some driving requirements. Due to the difference in structure, GaN FETs have a few key advantages that I wanted to highlight. The GaN FET has a lateral structure which helps it have a low gate capacitance, gate charge, output capacitance. This enables higher switching speeds with reduced gate drive losses and reduced switching losses. GaN FETs also have a low RDS on, which helps reduce conduction losses. Another advantage is that GaN FETs have zero reverse recovery charges, which leads to no reverse recovery losses, and also helps reduce ringing on the switch node as well as reduce electromagnetic interference. Here are some additional GaN benefits. GaN FETs have a low threshold voltage that is due to its lateral structure, low CGD, and its relationship between threshold and temperature, which is almost flat. The low threshold voltage means that there is low power dissipation, which leads to more efficient switching. Another benefit is that once the gate threshold voltage is reached, there will be enough electrons under the gate to form a conductive channel. This eliminates the minority carriers which are involved in conduction, and this is what helps there to be no reverse recovery losses. Another thing to remember is that GaN can be sensitive. So if you don't follow the recommended operating conditions, you may run into some issues in your design. Here you can see that GaN has a limited gate voltage range. A typical recommended operating turn-on gate voltage is 5 volts, with 6 volts generally being the maximum value. The recommended gate voltage for turn-off is negative 2 volts to avoid any non-desired turn-on events that could occur due to high voltage changes. These values may be different depending on the applications or part you are using, so we would recommend referring to the datasheets of the devices so that you can get the best performance out of your designs. We also have two devices, the LMG1210 and UCC27611, that can help you regulate the voltage through an internal LDO so that you can drive your FET at the appropriate voltage. To take advantage of the GaN technology benefits, it is important to use a GaN-specific driver in combination with the GaN FET. We recommend choosing a driver that can keep VGS around 4 to 5.25 volts, depending on which parts you are using. Having high peak output currents can also help with the turn-on and turn-off efficiencies. The speed of the switching characteristics is also important to keep in mind, so that you can achieve the highest speeds possible in your design. Having a small surface mount package can also help you achieve better results. The last thing to keep in mind is that the layout will also play a key part in your design. Having a good layout will help you reduce the parasitics so that you can get the best performance out of your design. In our GaN driver portfolio, we currently have 6 parts, 3 are half bridge and 3 are low side. Each category has one automotive qualified part. Our drivers have fairly low propagation delays with individual features that make each driver different. Some notable features include controllable dead times, bootstrap supply voltage clamps, internal bootstrap components, and an internal LDO for our half-bridge drivers. Similarly, our low-side drivers can feature an internal LDO and nanosecond pulse width capabilities. One driver might be better than the other depending on your application, so it would be best to check which one best fits your requirements. Here are some of the resources that I use if you would like to learn more about anything that I have covered today.